Hey everybody, how's it? Aloha, this is Jeeps, your old composer here at the Decomposer Lounge. Pulling back the layers, dissecting your favorite tracks. And this track is a special track. And I want everybody who is a Faith No More fan to thank the guy I'm doing this video for. His name is Damien. He's the one that put Billy in touch with me in order to get that Slow Burn released and unblocked. So of course I gotta do one for him, man. So this is for Damien. Thank you so much, man. Really super appreciate it. So does everybody else who checked out that video and is a fan of Faith No More. So that being said, he goes, well, there's a band that I'd like for you to check out. And the name of the band is Sunk Loto and from Australia. So I look them up and they had a 10-year run from 1997 to 2007. A little bit of a break, and it looks like they just came back to bat. It says here, this is Wikipedia now. excuse me. So it looks like they may have just came back together and might be doing some touring. They released two albums. And the song that I'm going to be doing is the song Help from, I think, and this is, let me take a quick look, scrolly, from their 2003 album called Between Birth and Death. So outside of that, thank you all for your support. You know how to do that. You want to check out the headsets, cans, the links are down below for the coffee, the Patreon, the cans, and all that sort of fun stuff for support. All right, guys, here we go. This is from the band Sunk Loto. The song is Help. All right. I gotta stop right there. What an insane sound. What an insane band. You know, this is what this journey's about for me. And you know, I know a lot of my views have been tanking and stuff like that, and I'm doing all these obscure bands, but this is where I'm at with the channel. And when I find a gem like this, this is what makes me fully excited to be doing this, still doing reactions, you know, on this channel. And it's to come across bands that, how in the hell were these guys not gigantic? Enormously huge. I don't know, maybe they were, because remember, I didn't know much about all these subgenres or genres of metal until I started this channel. What great textures and passages they take us through. You know, that opening with the really super clean, haunting kind of guitar sound, but the chord changes were very kind of pulling and stuff. There was nothing about it that was predictable. And then when they come in with the power, they don't just come in with the power, but they really give you kind of a hangman swing of like different rhythm patterns that really caught me off guard. And I'm still kind of trying to process. I feel like I should just be going like process face for everything that's happening. Then to hear the vocals come in the very beginning, it was just very haunting, low, quiet little melody that was going on. Then he blows out this incredible tone in his voice, and then brings it back into, you know, a melody that has a melody and a singing performance that has sustainable notes that are not screaming and stuff. So that also shows with where I'm at right now. I've seen a couple of sides of the musicians, as I have of the lead singer already. That is so absolutely impressive. And the fact that they keep leaning in and out of these acoustic clean sounds, even if it's only for a 4-bar turnaround, you know, that's huge dynamics for me in production and stuff like that. And it's, you can see how I'm kind of like, you know, physically kind of twisting with each one of their changes. Man, that was a kick-ass track. I'm definitely going to listen to this a few more times today. There was so much that I want to absorb. You know, when it comes time to do these reactions sometimes and I get overwhelmed like this, it's only because of the fact that bands like this, as they write songs like this, they have to spend just as much time on the dynamics of the production and these, you know, stop starts coming in and out of clean sounds, going dark and heavy and stuff like that. And I was reading the lyrics, and the lyrics are pretty intense. I'll have the link for this Spotify, and the lyrics will be down below. I also like the fact, like, I don't know if it's part of the band or part of an overdub, but, you know, they just had that light kind of synth pad going behind. I think they had some in the front, they having some at the end that were just slightly behind, you know, the guitar, those really odd chords and that kind of a warm but dark sound in the tone of the guitars. From when I got back in after that last break to now, it was a completely different journey for me. So this is just one of those tracks where I'm just gonna have to listen to it a few times. But I await your comments on this. I mean, seriously, is this not one of the most badass tracks I've heard in quite a while? Not taken away from all the other reactions I've done. Anyhow, I don't know if I did it in any way, shape, or form any justice as a reaction of sorts, but I guess the only reaction authentically I can bring to you is, like, I was fucking blown away. And you guys know I don't cuss that much, so. Anyhow, so the name of the band was Sunk Lodo. The name of the song was Help. And once again, I want to thank Damien for the help you gave me with the Faith No More video. And for the folks, so you guys go ahead and leave comments about the song, but, you know, say thanks to Damien also in the comments. That'd be badass. All right, guys, take care of yourselves. I have, what do I have coming for the next Slow Burn? Oh, yeah, ISIS. Can you believe that? That's what I'm doing. All right, guys, take care. Have a killer day.